Smiley, where are you?
What you doing?
Look at that. That is perfect for the Arctic Circle and all those mozzies, isn't it? Perfect. That one is. Have a look at this one. This one is cream crackered. Look at that. So I think what we're going to have to do is whip it off, stick it on the bench and see if we can fix it. So I've had a look in here and you take those caps off. It looks like there's only four screws holding it on. So let's take the screws off. Watch this. Ta-da! That was easy, wasn't it? Let's go stick it on the bench, see what we can do.
This is going to be tricky. I think I can make it work though. But anyway, if I don't, it's already broken, so I haven't lost anything, have I? What you'll need is you'll need this. This is 1 millimeter cord that's waxed. I'm gonna use this stuff to, I've got 10 meters of it. Should be enough, shouldn't it? And what we've worked out, if you come here, but in fact, if you go here, there's four of these screws at each corner, which you have to remove. And when you've removed it, you get this mechanism away from the plastic body. Okay, so first thing you have to do, just slides out. And what I can deduce is that this cord starts in this corner and it's locked in by the Allen key. Can you see that? There's an Allen nut there. And it goes through that gap there, along there, through there, and does a loop the loop here and ends up in that corner there. Okay, so far, good. So what we have to do is take the new cord, thread it through, and see if it works. So I just poked it through that. I'm gonna slide it through the hole. Like that. And with my Allen key, lock it in place. Right, that needs to go up there. Cut this. It's going to go along there, it's going to go along there, it's going to go down there, it's going to go along there, and it's going to loop the loop backwards. It's going to go along there, along there, up to there, isn't it? Up there, and all the way down to there, and up there. So if I take another meter of it, that ought to be enough. So I've just discovered that you have to take this black thing off to get it through that hole there, so, and there's a screw here. And now that slides out.
So what are you doing now?
I've cut the old cord that's damaged and I'm just threading the new cord through the holes. So, we've locked him in there. The new cord goes along there, along here to this hole, up through the holes in the concertina stuff, comes along here, does a loop, continues along there, and we're now down to this. So I'm just going to pull him through now, the slack. In essence, it should just run along this bottom here and then lock into this Allen key nut there. Can you see that? It's the Allen key which is rusted in. Not good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply some heat. Perhaps I'll do this inside because it's a bit windy. Anyway, it's an old miner's trick. You apply some heat so that the metal expands, and then when it's cooled down, breaks the rust, is the theory. So that worked. Amazing. So now I've got a nut that works. We can now tighten up the mechanism that we put in. So let's go over here now. Slot that back in. The hole, which is, push that in there. And we can slot the new cord in like that. The new cord's in like that, a bit of slack. So I've had a parlay with myself, and I think this bit goes on first, and that goes, slots into there, and then we put that bit on second. So first, this tape was holding it all together, like that, so when we peeled it off, there's no sticky left. So what we're going to do is get some duct tape, trusty old duct tape, cut its shape, size, and put it on so all these cables stay in position. The duct tape is on. Now I just run my fingers down there so that it's all nice and sticky. Oh, come on. This is going to work. When you slide this top piece in, you have to make sure that these cables sit there. So it's quite a fiddly thing to do because they have to sit on top like that. The top bar, the concertina mesh is now back in the top bar. You just slide it in, and we've just put it in place for the time being so that we can assess how to tighten. These strings have got to be tight, so we need to slot the bottom piece in this metal bar that goes up and down like that, pull it through and tighten it up here and here. And I think we should be there. So we'll just do that and then we'll come back in a minute. All right. Are you ready? Watch. So in summary, if you need to repair this blind because the cord's gone, what you need to do is remove it from the wall, four screws, dead easy. Then take the caps off. There's four screws on the top and the bottom. Remove those and it just pulls apart. Then carefully replace the cord exactly how the old cord is wrapped. Tighten it all up, put it back. screw it all back in and it works. I hope that's been helpful. It's a very warm day and it's now time for a cold beer. See you later.